If I was to go back from scratch and start backtesting, this is exactly what I would do. First, find a strategy. First, find a couple of concepts, maybe ICT, SMC, whatever. Just find those concepts, write it down on a paper, write down your session timings, everything. Make a rough trading plan. We'll call this trading plan test one. Then go on FX Replay, go on TradingView, and forward test, backtest, whatever you can do. Just backtest the exact same plan and see what your winning trades look like, what your losing trades look like, all of that stuff. And you should also journal this. So shortly, I'm just going to show you how I journal it and what things I look for to take my strategy from a test one to a test two, a test three, and so on. All these tests, all they mean is that I'm just improving and refining my strategy each time by finding frequent things which are making me lose trades, right? So let's say if I'm on a Monday, I'm constantly losing trades. Well, scrap the Monday, okay? And that's how you refine your trading plan. But have a checklist of criteria to tick before you take a trade in your first strategy backtest. And now let's just get on to how to journal and how you should actually lay everything out. So the next stage is actually going on Notion, Excel, whatever, and finding that strategy and journaling. So as you can see on a bearish daily bias, I have all of these notes made on what usually tends to happen. And same with a bullish daily buy. So as you can see, example one, example two, all of these things. And I'll be coming out with a Notion template for free, which I'll give to you so you can do the same thing as so. And also write some notes, but the main thing is your strategy. So this is FX Replay. I've just taken some screenshots, but this shows the strategy of 2021, my results, all of these things in terms of total winners, total losers, max losing streaks, max winning streaks, all of these good things. Average win, best win, like worst loss, all of those things. But this is where the main things happen off your strategy. You want to make a table of winners and of losing trades, and then just fill out whatever makes sense for your strategy. So for example, in my strategy, the confluences are all of these, but in your strategy, it might be something different. So include that. So, and also if you want me to make a video on how to make these journals, how to make these templates, then let me know in the comments below and I will get recording and make that, because it's really, really crucial and it's not even that hard from my side. So have this, winners and losers, journal every single trade, all of these things, results. If you're targeting liquidity, so it might be a 6% or a very high risk to reward, what was the result? If you're targeting a fixed 2R, 3R, what was the result? And if there's any news, things like that. And after the trade, if you have any notes, anything you've seen in particular, just write that there as a note. But after around quite a few trades, you will have your winners and losers, and now you can actually start refining and seeing what in the losing section is constantly happening. So for example, something in the losing section which you might see, I'm just looking, eyeballing it, is the Asian pips, the range of the Asian session, how many pips was it? So in my winners, as you can see, is 10 to 30, I would say. It's between that range. Obviously you'll have some outliers, for example a 32 pip, but it's still on the lower side of 30. Whereas if you look at my losers, what do we have? 38 pips right there, and that's it, to be fair. But yeah, 38 pips, that's quite high on the higher end, so that's a losing trade. Then things like maybe a specific day. So if I'm just looking at my day column, the winners seem to be Wednesday's pretty good, Tuesday's pretty good. On my losing column, something which constantly occurs is Thursday, to be fair. But so if you can't know it from here, then you can always go on FX Replay and just go to each day and see your win rate for that. Something else is the break of market structure timing. Is there a specific time of which you're more profitable? So maybe after 8 a.m. you're more profitable, or maybe after 9 a.m. you're more profitable. Maybe pre 7 a.m., maybe pre 8 a.m. you're not profitable, or it's like not very high likely chance of winning a trade. So you can scrap that out. So that's essentially what I'm trying to get into you guys today, is that all you have to do is journal, keep journaling, keep refining, gain that confidence, and pretty much that's it. That's how I would backtest if I would start again. And I would keep refining my strategy, keep finding little things, little tweaks, 1% tweaks, which can improve my strategy in the long term and also improve my overall win rate, risk to reward. But improving strategy doesn't mean just keep increasing your win rate to an 80% strategy, okay? You should have a strategy which gives you a positive ROI. That's it. You shouldn't be focusing on that, okay, I'm getting around 2 to 3% a month with a 40% win rate, but my strategy still isn't really good because I want a 60, 70% win rate. You're going to lose and you just have to accept that. But refining and finding common things which keep making you lose, that is the key to actually improving your strategy, rather than just trying to win all the time, because it's so hard. And trust me, I haven't understood this. I'm still in my learning stage. It's been like 2 years. I'm in my third year of trading, but it's still so hard to understand that losing is just a part of the game. And whether you like it or not, this is the game we're playing and you are going to lose. It's not good, it's not nice, but in some ways, if we kept winning, then it would just be boring. So losing is a part of the game. You have to accept it. And I feel like with time, I'm definitely getting better, but it's a constant learning thing, which is why experience is so crucial. Sticking to the plan, experience, all of these things. But that's all for today's video on how I would backtest if I would start again. If you want me to go in depth with how I backtest every single thing, maybe I can make a 1 hour video, maybe 30 minutes, of me backtesting 1 month and journaling every single trade live with you. So if that sounds interesting and of value to you, then let me know in the comments below and I will get to work on that. But enough for today. Ton of value given. Hope you got the value and hope you've taken something away from this. And that's all from my side. Happy trading. Stay safe. I will see you in the next one.